Hello everyone, it's Applemead Briars and welcome to my model horse room. Today I thought it'd be fun to film an updated collection tour, and it's been a little while, I think at least 18 months since I did a collection tour, and my collection has definitely grown in that time. First up, I thought I'd show you just a general layout of my room in case you're interested in what's in my hobby room. So here's the main shelves with mainly Briar OF traditionals, and then we have some stablemates over there. Underneath my shelves where I keep some of my photography setups, so we've got the barn setup, a cross-country diorama that I made for live showing, and an arena that's built for photography of traditionals as well. I've got a light box which is there for photo showing and photography, and then I have another converted wardrobe which holds yet more Briar model horses in there. And then if I spin round, we've got this, which is for stablemate photography. Unfortunately, the stable has kind of collapsed a little bit, so that does need some repair work. And then up here, I have my really cool little wooden horse sculpture that's made out of like driftwood. And then we've got some sketches from the Briar Premier Club. So that's kind of the layout of my room. I'll just spin round and then we can have a look at the models. Starting on the top shelf here, we have Reverence, who was a Briarfest 2021 limited edition. We've got the regular Marwari and Nasruddin, who was the 2017 Briarfest celebration horse. We've got the Lipizzana regular Favourite Ariel, I think she's called. The Christmas horse Celestine from 2018, I think she's from. And she's next to another Christmas horse, this is Arctic Grandeur from 2021. We've got Dominante, Straight Bet, who was a Briarfest special run from 2018, and he's glossy. Duende from the Premier Club. And then we'll move on to some Cantering Warmbloods. So I've got Danny, the celebration horse from Briarfest 2021, Catch Me, and True North from the Premier Club. Continuing along, we've got my Silver Black Slancher Surprise from Briarfest 2020. There's Avatar's Jazzman, who's a regular run. Chardonnay, a limited edition from Briarfest 2022. Velegro, Celtic Salonero. And then we have some web special unicorns. So we've got Alicor and Diadem. There's Mira and Antares, Speaker and Bellatrix. We've got Cascade and Caspian, who are regular runs. And then Xavier, who's actually the model who got me back into the model horse hobby. And then if we turn around the corner, these are kind of my decorator type stablemates. So there's some Halloween decorators up there, some from Briarfest, and then at the back there's also a classic Halloween model, Eek. Second shelf down, and we're starting, there's quite a few foals on this shelf. So there's the regular run, I can't remember this little foal's name, but he's a little Welshie. Behind him there's a custom that was done by Walnut Lane Studios, that's actually on a classic pony mould. We've got here Ares, I call him, he's the foal from the Lipizzana regular run set. Vixen, who is from the Best of Briarfest Hackney set. There is Tor, Comet, I call him again, from the Best of Briarfest set. And then we've got Astrid from the Premier Club. Behind them, here we've got Black Beauty, who was the web special Black Beauty. And then two Treasure Hunt Silvers, there's the Appaloosa and then the Rose Grey. And there we have the 70th anniversary Fighting Stallion. Coming back in front where we've got some more ponies, so there's Brookside Pink Magnum, Snickerdoodle. I can't remember this one's name either, but again, she's a fairly recent regular run on the fairly new Welsh pony mold. We then have Gingerbread, who is a web special. We've got Carlton Lima Emma. I've got the Sable Island pony there on the Croy mould. And then we have some Briarfest models. So there's Nicholas, who was the celebration model from last year's Briarfest. Chablis, who was a limited edition also from last year's Briarfest. Then there's the Ideal Series Quarter Horse, who's Chestnut. And we have two Sipbo Pine Bars. So this guy here is Rugged Painted Lark, who's very special. He was the celebration model for the only year that I've physically been able to attend Briarfest, which was when I was a child. So I hope to get back someday. Then next to him, I have here Zeke, who was a TSC special run. We've got Notoriously Framed from the Collector Club. This is the short mane and long tail version. There was a kind of 50-50 split with her. Minstrel, that was from the 2019 Christmas Horse. Peshmel, from 2021 Briarfest. He was a special run. And then here we have my Seven Arts for Pry, also from that year of Briarfest. He is the Champagne Splash, I believe. And he's sitting next to the Collector Club Birds of a Feather Special Meadowlark. We've got a Bobby Joe here, and this is Paint Me a Pepto. And then we have my couple of Fire Hearts. So we've got the main Fire Heart from Premier Club. There's Bolero from the Collector Club this year, who was the web kind of special for Collector Club. We've got Mini Fire Heart, because I thought it'd be cute to put him next to the big Fire Heart. And then here we have Helios, who was from the Stablemate Club last year, and I absolutely love him. We've got Firefly and Hawkeye from the Premier Club last year, or maybe the year before, I can't remember. And then we also got here Zafira. She was definitely from last year's Premier Club. Then we have lots of stablemates. I'm not going to go into them individually, but we do have kind of my favourite stablemate molds here. So I have some Darwins, which I absolutely love this mold. Some miniature Croys, because again, I think Croy is my favourite, especially in stablemate mold. She's just so cute. I actually prefer the stablemate mold to the traditionals. And then my ultimate favourite stablemate mold is this little Welsh pony. Currently got three of them. We've got two from the Collector Club Gambler's Choice last year. I just need to get the other two, which is the Welshie and Decorator. And then we've got Lyric from the Premier Club in the middle. So yeah, quite a lot of stablemates. I'm not gonna go through all of them because we'll be here for years. Bottom shelf now. So here we've got Dead Heat in the Palomino version. This is from Briarfest 2018. She was a special run. 70th anniversary on the Smarty Jones mold from 2020. This is Lafayette, who was from the Collector Club in 2021. And then we have my favourite boys, and probably my favourite mould at the moment. It changes sometimes, but I do really like these guys in a conga. So these are my Georgas. Georg? I still don't know how to say his name, that's quite embarrassing. Anyway, we've got Theo the regular run. There's Honey Bear from the Collector Club in 2022. The Briarfest 2022 special run, which is the Rhenish Draft. Then we've got Georg himself. And then there's a little mini one from the Premier Club last year. And then we have Oak. Moving on, here is a surprise horse from last year's Briarfest. He's the Grey Pinto, rotating draft surprise, and he is very cute. I'm going to zoom in on his little wall eye because I adore it. And then we've got my Altonis. So we've got the original Altonis from the Premier Club. Uffington, who was a major in search of for me for a while. And then here, sporting some endurance tack because I just haven't bothered to take it off him yet, which is quite bad. We have the regular run Adamek. Next to him, this is Vermeer from the Premier Club. And then we have some troubadours. So the original troubadour, Morgan Quest Nature's Son, and then Snowbird, who was the Christmas horse from last year. I've got two lovely medallions here. So this one was painted by Wonderland Muddle Horses and is a really, really nice Pegasus. It really reminds me of the Pegasus from the Hercules movie, and I really, really adore that. And then this here is a sculpt of an Andalusian medallion that I got from Summer Willow Live last year and was painted by Maddie Bennett. Then here we have Alboroso, my absolute favourite traditional. I thought he was overhyped to begin with, but I actually see the appeal of him now. Like, he's just such a lovely sculpt. I adore him, and he's hanging out with Animar from last year's Premier Club because I think they just look awesome together. Then we have Constantia, and finally a slightly wonky, now I look at her, Ardemisea Bay, who's a new regular run from this year. And then finally more stable mates here, and some like teeny weeny little micro horses that I got a live show last year. And I do really like this Clydesdale Mold and this Clydesdale Foal. They're so cute. We've moved on into the wardrobe now, so this is kind of converted to hold more horses. So here's a work in progress, slightly primed Theo, a Kelpie custom that I did for Halloween last year. Maelstrom, who was last year's Halloween horse, and then he's hanging out with Kalahari, who was from the Wild Animal Series Collector Club. And then I have a Spice Drop from the Collector Club. She was a Christmas morning special. And I've got two of the show jumping warmbloods up here. So this is Mongammon and then a custom. Dropping down, we've got Fox Valley Oliver. He's with Marcus, the Best of British Shire horse, Benelli, Bahana, and Yuletide Greetings. These are my Shannondales. Hoping to pick up another Shannondale from Briarfest this year. And then I'm going to have to find a new space for Fox Valley Oliver. This shelf is a bit of a mix. It's got thoroughbreds at the back and then some customs at the front, because I like to keep these guys out of the way where I'm not going to knock them over. So here we've got Red Rum. He was my very original first ever Briar Traditional. He is pretty much body quality, but I love him and he gets to chill. We've got Seabiscuit with his slightly wonky and crazy eyes, but I love him as well. We've got Tis the Law, fairly new regular run. Chadwick from the Collector Club, Emerson, and then Winx, who's just hanging out in some racing tack that, again, I do need to take off her. That might be my job after I finish this video. Then we have some customs here. So the really awesome purple Alborozo is a custom by Wonderland Model Horses. He's actually the very first model I've ever commissioned. And I adore him. He just looks like a little demon, and I just love his expression and paint job. So he is a really awesome little model. Next to him, there's my this year's Namo Paymo model, which is a resculpted stable mate. It was a G3 standing thoroughbred that I resculpted the neck and mane on. Here we have Icarus, which is a sculpt by Kelly Seeley, and I painted that one to be like a buckskin fantasy horse. Then we've got Pegaso, who was a sculpt by Clarity Studios UK. He's kind of inspired by Birds of Prey, and you can't really see his colours very well in this lighting, but he's like a silver bay. And then here is a Vincenzo, that's the word. Weir Vincenzo I painted to a blue roan. He does need a little touch up on his tail, as I did get a little mark on him, but he can't stand very well, so he has to stand with his little stand. And then finally, coming down to this shelf, I've got some sport horses here, so easy to spot. We then have Josie from Briarfest 2021, Voyeur, who's a regular run, Malino Castle, who was the 2020 celebration horse, and then my two newest acquisitions here, and one of the molds I have now got a newfound love for, the strapless mold. So we have Party Girl here, who was a JAH special run from 2008, and a Black Tie Affair, who is currently in the process of being my little body model for making some tack. Well, she's not really body, she's not live show quality, but she's definitely good enough to photo show. She's very cute. And then some more little custom-y things here that I've painted. This little Frisian is by Clarity Studios UK. I think he's called Geralt. And I customised him to be like this blue-black. We've got this little tiny micro at the front and the smallest model horse I painted. This is Arcus from Sunny Equine Studios that I painted to a bay. Behind him, you can't really see very well. This is the Lying Down Black Beauty sculpt from Clarity Studios UK, who is a blue roan appy. Let me see if I can show you his appy. There we go. He's a little blue roan appy. And then one of my favourite things I've ever painted, this is Griffin, who's an Irish cob sculpt, again by Clarity Studios UK, because I'm obsessed with their stuff. And he is there as a little ski board. And then in this box, hiding from sunlight because it's a 3D printed model, is my little Union Jack foal to be painted. It's literally so tiny. Resist showing you how tiny that little foal was. So this is Union Jack, who I need to prime and paint. But he's very cute and I can't wait to get some paint on him. Into the last section where I keep my models, up here we've got a Picasso. He actually has a broken ear. He was bought as a body, and at some point I will hopefully do some customising with him. We've got Lancelot, as I call him. He is a regular run on the Lusitano, like a spree mould. And then up here, I really need to find a better place for him because I feel he just doesn't fit, but I don't know where else to put him. I've got my Briarfest 2021 Special Run Gran Caballo. The only Peter Stone in my collection. This is a designer horse on the Remington mould. I didn't design him. I just saw him for sale and I really like chestnuts, and he is a really cool chestnut and I absolutely adore his face marking. He's so cool and he's really awesome for photography. So he is a newfound favourite and I kind of want some more Peter Stones now. We've got Lady Liberty. She was a special run from 2007 Briarfest. Again, that was the Briarfest I attended in person. She doesn't really get to see like a lot in terms of photography or showing because she is a bit cartoony, but I love her anyway for those memories. She's not the sort of special run I would choose these days, but she gets to stay for the nostalgia factor. And then we have Encore, the regular run from 2020, and Huynh, another regular run. We've got Nakota. This is a custom in the middle here by Coletto Studios UK. It's a resculpted Briar Arabian type mould. I can't remember what the mould's called. Yasmin, that's it. I resculpted Jasmine to be a Morab, and she's very cute, and the detail on her is insane. Her hooves are just incredible, so I absolutely love her. I don't have many customs in my collection, as you'll see, but she is like staying because she's beautiful. Got Earth from the Elemental series. We've got Polaris, who was a tour model for Briar. And then down here I have a regular run, Gypsy Vanner, with Cheesecake, who was from 2020 Briarfest. He's the matte version, it's a limited edition. This twisty boy down here is Bolero. He's a fairly new sculpt from Clarity Studios UK. He's hiding in the cupboard. I usually keep this side dark and kind of alternate where he sits so he doesn't get exposed to sunlight too often. But he is on my to-do list to prime and paint. Here we've got the lovely Croy. This girl's markings and colours and dapples are just stunning. I absolutely love her. She's fairly new. She came to me from Mr. Bobby's Models, who reached out because she knows I love Premier Club models. So thank you for her. And then I have here, this was the Best of British Irish Draft. And finally, my last little bit of the shelves. These are kind of carpet herd models, if you like, that I've kept, again, for nostalgia reasons. We've got Justin Morgan. There is Blackjack, Fire Magic, and Milton. I hope you've enjoyed taking a little tour of my model horse collection. Let me know in the comments who your favourite model in my collection is or who you'd like to steal. And I will see you very soon in another video. Bye bye!